آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship other than Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. For Muslims, they must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have the taqwa of Allah, be God conscious, and don't die unless you are in a state of total submission. Today, in this khutbah, inshallah, I'd like to remind myself as well as the believers with a form of ibadah that is very important and is a high rank. وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us about one of his prophets, the prophet Noah alayhi salam. And he told us, إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. He was a humble slave, servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To be grateful, to be thankful, to be dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He himself is a shakur. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who credit us, although that Allah does not need to credit anyone, because He created you, fashioned you, He made everything for you. But still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reward you for whatever that good deed that you do. A Muslim is supposed to be concerned about how to get closer to Allah. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to call on Allah saying, Allahumma a'inni ala dhikrika wa shukrika wa husni ibadatik. Oh Allah, enable me. So you need the help of Allah. For what? Help to do what? To remember you, to be grateful to you, to be thankful of you, and to worship you in the best manner. This is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the one had stood up in night prayer until his feet swelled up. He is the one who cried out of the fear of Allah until he wet his beard. And still the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking and begging Allah to help him. Because if Allah did not help you to be grateful, to be thankful, you are not going to see the ni'mah. You are not going to see the blessing of Allah. And you will be in a condition not to receive anymore. If a person in this life, no hands, no legs, nothing except a piece of flesh, sitting on a chair, moved by somebody else to put him in the bed, still, when if Allah had choose you and make you Muslim, if Allah open your mind and your heart to know the oneness of Allah, you are rich. You are being blessed, and you should be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything that He gives you. فَإِنَّهَا لَا تَعْمَى الْأَبْصَارِ وَلَكِنْ تَعْمَى الْقُلُوبُ الَّتِي فِي الصُّدُورِ. It's not that the vision turn blind, but it's the heart that in the chest it turn blind. You don't see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانًا وَشَفَتَيْنِ وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. Did we give him two eyes to see with, and a tongue to talk with, and two lips, and we guided him and show him the two paths, kufr or Islam. There is nothing else. Islam is one unit, one ummah. Everything else is kufr and disbelief and away from the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be grateful, be thankful, count your blessings. What does it mean you have millions of dollars and you did not know La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah? What the money can make for you? We have to understand that we need to ask Allah to make us grateful. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling us and advising us sallallahu alaihi wasallam, انظروا الى من هو اسفل منكم لا تنظروا الى من هو اعلى منكم فانه اجدر الا تزدروا نعمة الله عليكم. Look to those who less fortune than you. Don't look to those who have more than you, because otherwise you never can be grateful and thankful to Allah. If you have one arm, look to somebody who have no arms. If you have no arms, see somebody who have no arms, no legs. If you can move only your eyes right and left, see somebody who could not move anything of his body or in his life. We need to open our hearts, open our eyes to see the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he told us about Nuh alayhi salam, ذُرِّيَّةَ مَنْ حَمَلْنَا مَعَ نُوحٍ إِنَّهُ كَانَ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Allah choose Noah alayhi salam and label him to be a grateful and thankful. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يرضى عن أحدكم إذا أكل اللقمة أو شرب الشربة حمد الله سبحانه وتعالى. Of those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the giver, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still grateful to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remember you and reward you when you do something good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is Ash-Shakur, and this is His name. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have to give any of us anything in return. But still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us in the hadith al-Qudsi, من تقرب إلي شبرا تقربت منه ذراعا ومن تقرب إلي ذراعا تقربت منه باعا ومن أتاني يمشي أتيته هرولا. Whosoever come closer to me, how you get closer to Allah? With the good deed, with the obedience of Allah, with facilitating things for others. We see the ibadah only to be salah. Look to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he told us about this woman that was a prostitute, but Allah had forgave her due to the fact that she gave a dog some water to drink. A prostitute, sinful, and she was thirsty, and she looked for water. Finally, she found a well of water. She went and she satisfied herself. When she came out, found a dog eating and sucking the dirt to take the water out of it. She said, indeed, this dog became worse than me few minutes ago. She went to bring water. She don't know how to bring the water out. She went and filled her shoes, hold it with her teeth, climb out and come and give a dog. Can you imagine if you do something good to a Muslim or a handicapped or an elderly person, a needy person, how we can be grateful? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see and yashkur li wa li walidayk إلي المصير. First Allah, then come your parents, then comes your neighbors, then comes all those people that in the Muslim community. We have to understand that the shukr and to be grateful and thankful is a form of ibadah. It's not going to be a four rak'at, it's going to be your action. It can be your thoughts, how you can assist, how you can help, how you can be there for the people. With our action, we can say Alhamdulillah. With our ibadah, we can say Alhamdulillah. It's not a matter of only saying Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in al-hadith al-Qudsi, إِنَّ عَبْدًا أصححت له جسمه ووسعت عليه في المعيشة تمضي له 5 سنوات لا يفد إلي لمحروم. Indeed, a person whom that I give him health and wealth and made the road safe for him 5 years ago without visiting me, coming to make Hajj or Umrah, this person is deprived. Is deprived. Why? Because it's not a matter of saying Alhamdulillah. Let your action talk. Let your ibadah translate your gratitude. And instead of saying it by your tongue, by your action. 5 years, and you still did not see the Kaaba, you did not saw the Haram, you did not go around the Kaaba, and you went to Paris, you went to England, you went here and there for tourism, but about Hajj, you did not see even the Kaaba yet. 5 years, Allah gave you opportunity, even if you made Hajj, even you made Umrah one time before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see you coming back to Him, showing your gratitude. If you did not do, you are not grateful, thankful to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you be grateful, thankful, I will give you more. So if you're looking for more from the favor and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, translate this in your action and get closer to Allah as much as you can. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. الله سبحانه وتعالى saying وقليل من عبادي الشكور. Little and few among my slaves servant, because you enslave yourself or you a slave without enslaving yourself. Allah wants you to show your slavery being abd. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, عبادي, those who worship me. A lot of worshipers. A lot of people making salah. A lot of people making hajj. But to be grateful and thankful and pleased with Allah, say, brother, what you talking about? I've been with this sickness all my life. But you still can walk. You can go to your car. You still can drink water. You don't want somebody to put the water, sip the water to you. Let's count our blessings. Let's try to understand we're so rich, we have a lot. Don't focus about what you don't have. Focus about what Allah gave you and be thankful. And if you want more, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, the way for more, وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you be grateful and thankful, sharing, helping others, I will give you more. My brothers and sisters in Islam, today I'm standing here before you to say thank you and jazakum Allah khairan for those 8 or 10 brothers who had help for preparing for Salat al Eid. I'm grateful and thankful. And without your help, after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we could not have it. Thank you very much. The best that I can say to you, جزاكم الله خيرا. But guess what? 8 brothers, or even say 10, that means we have 1% our population of the mosque that they trying to help, to contribute, to assist. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He gives those who turn to Him, those who show mercy to others. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be merciful to them. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying, من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله. Whosoever is not grateful to the people, he could not be grateful to Allah. Somebody taught you Fatiha, be thankful. Somebody give you a dollar and kept a dollar, be thankful. You want really to thank Allah in action. Not on a dhikr beads and you sit down and 33 times and say Alhamdulillah, this is good, you say Alhamdulillah. But show action, show concern, and show gratitude especially for those who did not know Islam or see Islam or heard about Islam. Share the information. Talk to the people about Allah. Let the people know what is missing out of their life, especially in America. They have everything, the convenience, everything. One thing is missing is Islam. Who have it? You and me and we. But are we doing something to show our gratitude that Allah had made us Muslims? It is a blessing. Because if you have the whole dunya, you have the whole dunya, and you die without Islam, you are a loser. You are a loser. So my dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, I'm very grateful to those 10 brothers. I don't know if any sisters had help, but if any sisters had help, may Allah also bless them. And I pray that Allah bless those brothers and those sisters and those who stood up there to be standing, watching, waiting for everything to be ready to sit and make the takbir and make the eid. I'm grateful to everybody. And inshallah, Allah will help us to be thankful and grateful and remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said that وَلَئِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you be grateful and thankful, I will give you more. So if you want more from the favor and the blessings of Allah, put the down payment. Take a step towards Allah. Come closer to Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Ghafoor, Al-Shakoor, the one who take the hasana and give 10 hasana and give up to 700. So be grateful to the ni'mah of Islam. وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا. Remember the favor of Allah. Remember that you are a Muslim, you have Islam, you have Quran, you can read in the Quran, spend from it. Teach somebody, help somebody, assist somebody, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can give you more and more. I beg Allah's forgiveness for me and you and all the Muslims. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all the brothers and sisters who had helped us especially for preparing for Eid, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all the Muslims everywhere. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be in the aid for the people, all the Muslims everywhere, and especially for the people of Gaza and all the people that is suffering from the persecution and from the all suffering that we did not even hear or imagine that is happening, and people are watching. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala victory for Islam and Muslims. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillah.